Hi, I'm Michael Britton, and excuse the mess. This is an art studio, and I'm always up to something in here. Now, in this lesson, the second lesson of the Structures of Beauty, we're discussing the Notan. Well, the whole thing is actually unity, and unity being the most important element of a painting. But the underpinning of unity is the Notan. Notan is a Japanese term for dark-light harmony. I prefer dark light over black and white harmony. Black-white is just too harsh, and it's too, well, it can be ugly. And I'm sure there will be many who will take issue with that. In this demonstration, we're going to embark upon Rembrandt's Old Man in a Military Costume, sometimes referred to as sad sack in a feather cap. So be it. Now, the overall dimensions of this painting, it was painted around 1630, is 65.7 by 51.8 centimeters. And I prefer metric because the math is more accurate and it's easier to punch out on a calculator or on my fingers. So to do our small copy, and I'm just going to begin on an 8 by 8 inch square canvas, and I'm going to tape it down to the dimensions of Rembrandt's actual painting here. So 65.7 by 51.8, give me a ratio of 1.272. And what do you know? 1.272 is the square root of the golden rectangle, which is known as phi. So hence, we're dealing with a dynamic rectangle in this canvas. But, as always, I digress. Many apologies. We're going to use a very limited palette here. We're just going to use white, black, raw umber, and yellow ochre. Now, if you're a real hardcore stickler to color theory, substitute the raw umber for burnt umber. The burnt umber will suffice for your red, the yellow ochre, your yellow, ivory or vine black, it's technically a blue, and there's your three primaries. Red, yellow, blue, plus tint, which is your white. However, I'm just going to get a little more fancier, even though we're at a very beginner level. Raw umber is technically a green. And green will push its neighbors towards the complement, which is red. That's called simultaneous contrast. Ah, there I go again. I digress. Many, many apologies. We'll cover that along with the root phi rectangles in quickly forthcoming lessons coming to a small screen near you. Okay, let's begin with mixing up some colors. I'm going to use a very simple palette here of just titanium white, yellow ochre, raw umber, and vine black. I prefer vine black over ivory black, and that's just a personal choice. We want to keep this quite simple. Remember, this is the Notan, dark light harmony. So, first I'm just going to mix up a dark value, raw umber, vine black, about 50-50, and just a little touch of medium here. This is just 50-50 terps and walnut oil. But you can use linseed oil, stand oil, whatever you got. Because this is a one-shot deal. It's an Alla Prima, Notan. And so this will be my dark. And with yellow ochre and a touch of white, I'm going to mix up my light. As I mentioned earlier in my somewhat sane introduction, Okay, I don't want black and white. It's just a bit too harsh. Instead of, I just want a light dark harmony. But again, I want huge difference between values. I want a punchy dark and a punchy light. Okay, and I'm going to mix up a third value here. Just going to be an intermediate value. Take my light, add some more yellow ochre to it. A little bit of umber, just to knock it down. I'll make sure the full value steps. Okay, and I use my knife so I get a nice cohesive batch of color, like cookie dough. No one likes clumps of flour in their cookies. Okay, three value steps there. In painting practice, I find it a good idea to work out my color harmonies as far as I can on the palette. You don't want to be messing about your color harmonies on your canvas. Note, the mess on here becomes a mess on your painting. Okay, let's get cracking to this Notan. Because we want to reduce our Notanal Pochade to its absolute essence, I'm not going to work from an image of Rembrandt's painting. Here, I just did a quick sketch, a ballpoint ink, roughing out my root 5 rectangle and applying a very simple grid to it. Those two horizontal lines that are demarcated by the number 1 are called rebotments. A rebotment is a square imposed upon the canvas. Now, I've also indicated a horizontal line that demarcates the center line, and also two diagonals, which helps me place the figure. Ooh, look at that semicircle I inscribed in the upper rebotment of the picture. The feathered cap touches upon that line, and that's a very important compositional element. But again, just like a politician making promises, I'm going to cover this in more depth in a later lesson. This will be on the harmonious divisions of space. Now, since I so gleefully mentioned this arc, I'm just going to take sort of a compass-like thing here. So from the rebotment, top of the canvas, describe that semicircle hits center point right about right there. It's a bit awkward, I know, but and very crudely indicate my arc in there. And enough of my digressions, because the focus here is on the Notan. Okay, I'm going to go to my dark. Load up my brush. It's just a medium-sized filber. Always choose the right size brush for the job. And I'm just going to quickly rough in the dark elements. Oops. You know, I'm not too crazy about working off of grids, because things can go horribly, horribly wrong, which they did if you get the wrong placements on the grid. I'm just going to go back to my usual method of just freely sketching it in, because I made the head too small. Oh, naughty, naughty me. I'm just laying this brush strokes in all different directions, roughing it in. Okay, there we go. Well, mostly what I'm looking for is the overall design. Now, Rembrandt's working process was to first get in the background. And I'm going to go to that right now. Mostly what I'm looking for is just want to keep a keen eye on the sense of design. And just drawing in with the brush. You know, Rembrandt would leave a reserve there, but since we already have it in, And scrub it in. Don't be painting like a little old lady. No, 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 no. You want energy. This is what attracts the viewer. This is what engages the viewer. It's a sense of energy. And you can let this imprimatura shimmer through. And my easel's kind of rocking like a groupie here. The painters get groupies. But with the rocking, you can get a sense of just how energetically I'm applying this paint. Now, every painter worth their salt will first do an Notanal Pochade, this thumbnail sketch. I think it's unlikely Rembrandt would have had the model standing in at this point. He's just painting on his own, out of his imagination. He has a rough idea of what he wants to paint. You know, how would this painting be first engaged at a distance? And then a little bit for the face in here. I think we need anything more than that. Of course, there is a breastplate here. I don't have it on my sketch, but I'll go back then into the background, because we're always working our figure-ground relationship. Figure is, well, the figure. The ground is the background. And it's not much of a tonal distance here, but we can take the Notan a little bit further. A great part of that I like about backgrounds is you really get to play with this full autographical expression. This is your handwriting. Just, you know, don't be timid about it. Timidity will get you nowhere. It's feeling a bit awkward in here. That feels a lot better. But then again, this is fixed. It's like a car. Get one thing fixed, then something else needs attention at the shop. A little bit higher tint in here. So now it's kind of at a playing at, well, what would Rembrandt do? Okay, there's many levels of copying. There's the copying for veracity, for learning your brushworks, for developing your abstract structural surface. But what we're focused on here is design. Stepping away and looking at my Notanal Pochade, I am not very happy with it. It lacks the elegance of the original Rembrandt. So I'm going to pull up the original image. I'll get away from my ballpoint pen sketch because that took me a fair distance, but it's kind of left me stranded on a backcountry road, on a moonless night. Kind of night that werewolves like to devour painters. Okay. Let's just fix this. This cap is a little thicker in through here. And more of a circle there. It's much more of an elegant rhythm to it. You know, and by making these corrections, this is how you learn. Make the mistakes. Don't shy away from them. I can see two. Need to fix this drawing in through here. I just use my brush handle to indicate my drawings here. Okay, and this should come up a little bit higher. And yes, I do talk to myself. Again, making these corrections is I'm training my mind's eye. I'm training it to recognize good design. And we only do that through copying. It's looking better. The feather's still looking a bit awkward. Also in these Notanal pochades, great opportunity to work out your brush strokes. There's nothing to lose. It's a small, inexpensive canvas. Better to lose a pochade than to lose a major canvas.